Today we are going to talk about the co-city verbs help, have, make, get, and let. What? Co-city verb? What does it mean? We use a co-city verb to talk about something that someone else did for us. It means we caused the action to happen but didn't do it ourselves. Maybe we paid or asked or convinced the other person to do it. We are going to start with help, just because this is the easiest one. You know the meaning of help. When you cannot do something by yourself, you need another person to help you. And when we use it as a co-city verb, the structure is help someone to do something. The word to is in parentheses because this is optional. You can include it if you want to, but you don't need to. Using this structure, here are some examples. I helped my mother cook dinner. My mother helped me do my homework. And I helped an old lady to cross the street. Now, let's look at have. The structure that we use is have someone do something. You can see that we don't use to. In this structure, we always use the base form of the verb. When we use have as a co-city verb, we tell someone or ask someone or pay someone to do something for us. For example, please have her call me back when she returns. That means, when she returns, please tell her to call me back. I had the electrician look at my broken light. It means that I asked the electrician to look at my broken light and he did. I'm going to have my students decorate the bulletin board. It means that I'm going to tell my students to decorate the bulletin board and they are going to do it. We can also have something done, and this is basically the same, but we don't say here who is doing it. For example, I had my car washed yesterday. It means that I had someone wash my car yesterday. Or I have my house painted every year. It means every year I have someone come to my house and paint it. To make someone do something is very similar. When we use the word make, it's very clear that they cannot say no. They will have to do it even if they don't want to do it. It's like we force someone to do something. And again, you can see that we are using the base form of the verb and not to. For example, the teacher made the students obey the school rules. It means that each student had to obey the school rules even if they didn't want to. The principal made the students speak English in the campus. It means that even though the students were not interested to speak English in the campus, they had to speak. My parents made me wear a helmet. It means that my parents told me that I could only ride a motorbike if I wore a helmet. I didn't have another option. Get someone to do something is used when the other person doesn't want to do it, but we convince them to do it. And in this structure, we need to include the word to. For example, my mother called me to help her with the dishes. It means that at first I didn't agree to do the dishes, but she explained me why it was important to do the dishes. So I agreed and did it. I get my dog to come inside by giving her a treat. My dog never wants to come inside, but if I give her a bone or a snack, she will. My brother got me to buy him a new mobile phone. At first, I didn't agree to buy him a new mobile phone. But he told me a few reasons why it was important for him to have one. And those reasons seemed logical to me, so I decided to buy one. And we also have get something done. And this is basically the same as have something done. However, get something done is less formal. Therefore, I personally prefer to use get something done. For example, she got a new photo taken for her passport. It means that she asked someone to take a photo for her and they did. He got his washing machine fixed. It means that his washing machine went kaput and he asked the mechanic to repair it. He came and did it. To let someone do something basically means that you allow someone to do something or you give someone permission to do something. Again, in this structure too, we don't use to. For example, my boss lets me work from home 3 days per week. It means that 3 days per week, I can decide whether I want to work from home or go into the office. Parents let their children watch 1 hour of TV per day. It means that if they want to watch TV, they can, but only for 1 hour. So yeah, this is how we use the 5 main causative verbs. Hope you enjoyed learning with me. If you like my videos, please share and subscribe my channel. Thank you.